Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing a DIY shirt video, so if you like what you see, keep on watching, grab your tools, and let's get started. So what you'll need are some rubber bands, paint brushes, a sharp tool, acrylic paint, and bleach. So after you've gathered all the materials, what you want to do is you're going to get all of your rubber bands and you're going to start bunching your shirt into little sections, and I just did them randomly. I'm gonna love you better. Show me what's on your mind. Tell me where you want to go and where you want to end up, baby. Then after you rubber banded everything, you're going to want to go outside and bleach the knots until you get the color that you want. So I left in the sun for about 2 hours and it looked like this. So then after the shirt was dried, I started painting on the Triforce and the Adidas logo, and it took a little while, but just make sure that you have the shirt dried after it's bleached, because you want to make sure that the paint doesn't seep through the shirt. I also ended up getting my cousin involved in this as well, so if you have extra hands, definitely take advantage of them. And there you go, this is the final product, and I think this is honestly such a really cool idea, and this is me just being funny. Alright, on to the next one. So this second shirt is a glue resist shirt, and I actually got the idea from Tatiana, which is another YouTuber, and her channel is honestly amazing, you should check it out. So what I did is that I went on SheInside, I think, and I got an inspiration from a shirt, and I just started drawing the shapes and lines with glue, and then I waited until it dried, and I got something really awesome. So next, what I basically did was that I had like a weird type of coloring, so I just tried to dilute the solution and make it enough so that I can dip the shirt into it. So basically after that, I started dipping the shirt into the color, and then I waited a couple minutes each time I dipped it for each side. So then after, you can see it in the video, when I started dyeing it, the paint kind of didn't like settle at the bottom, so it made kind of spots. But I mean, I thought it was kind of cool, but then when I washed it, like all the color fell out, so I had to keep on re-dyeing it, and then I ended up filling out the lines that were supposed to be glue resist with white paint, and it actually came out really cool. So the last shirt that I ended up doing was the unicorn one, and honestly I really think that this one is my favorite. I love it so much. So first I just started drawing out the numbers freehand on some, I think it was wax paper, but that didn't end up right, so I ended up using contact paper, and then I painted in the numbers. Then after, I just cut out the letters with my sharp tool, in this case it was a scalpel, and then I painted them, and then the shirt came out eventually like this in the back. So next, again, I just started cutting out the shape that I wanted and placing on the shirt, and so yeah, basically I just started with the pastel blue color, and then I tried to fade it into purple and into pink, and I think it turned out really awesome. Alright, so here is the final result for that shirt. Alright, bye guys, and have a great day.